2018 Ford F-150 Raptor interior review. The Raptor's comfy, laid-back interior is at odds with its macho visage. It's utilitarian in base form, but available features such as heated and cool front seats, leather seating surfaces, and unique color choices can add a touch of luxury. What's new for 2018? Ford obviously thinks the Raptor's interior is fine as is, despite its mediocre materials. There are no changes for 2018. 2017 Ford F-150 Raptor. Interior space comparisons. The SuperCrew cab could double as a studio apartment and offers class-leading rear seat legroom. The smaller SuperCab's back seat provides 33.5 inches of legroom, 10.1 inches less than the SuperCrew. Interior features. The interior has the same attractive and effective layout found on the regular F-150. Although the upper dash has soft touch materials, the abundance of hard plastics looks cheaper on the more exclusive Raptor. Likewise, the standard single-zone manual climate control is lackluster at this price, but an automatic dual-zone unit is optional. The chunky, standard leather-wrapped steering wheel feels great whether cruising or crawling. The optional ambient lighting has customizable colors, but we didn't like that it defaults back to blue whenever you turn off the truck. The giant center console shifter looks like the switch to restore power to Jurassic Park. But what seems bulky on the regular F-150 looks and feels appropriate here. An overhead panel of auxiliary switches is standard. It's perfect for aftermarket add-ons such as off-road lights. Modern cabins do an excellent job of insulating passengers from ambient noise, but none can completely eliminate the sharp wind and the drone of tire noise when you're traveling at highway speed. To measure the interior sound pressure level, we use a Brule Amp-Jer Type 2250L sound meter, which we position in the middle of the first row of seats at the height of the driver's ear. The meter automatically averages 15 seconds of sound in A-weighted decibels, dBA, taken while the test car is cruising at 70 mph. A-weighting is an industry standard that adjusts decibel readings to better reflect how the human ear hears various frequencies. We take two measurements and average the results. We also correct for speedometer inaccuracies with our GPS-based data loggers. It is worth noting that decibels are a logarithmic unit, so a rating of 40 decibels isn't twice the sound pressure of 20 decibels. It is 10 times the sound pressure. A 6 decibel increase roughly doubles the sound pressure. Despite its dual exhaust and big tires, the Raptor's interior is only slightly louder at 70 mph than most of its more demure competitors. Test results: interior sound levels at 70 mph. Seating and step-in height. Standard aluminum running boards help reduce the effort of climbing into the Raptor, which is about 3 inches higher than most trucks. To accurately measure seating height, the distance from the road to the driver's hip, we use an H-point machine, HPM, a precisely engineered device marketed by SAE International. This versatile tool, in conjunction with a laser device, reveals the width and location of roof pillar visibility obstructions, blind spots. Our HPM and laser measurement tools determine the length of road obscured by the hood as well as the road obscured by the trunk or hatch, as seen through the rearview mirror. Blind spots, visibility, and obscured roadway. Seeing objects that are close to the truck is a challenge for all high-riding pickups, but the Raptor is no worse than its competition. Add negotiating tight spaces to the Raptor's list of challenges, as its special off-road suspension and big tires increase its width by 6.4 inches versus the already wide regular F-150. Standard rear parking sensors and an optional 360-degree camera make precarious maneuvers much more manageable. Roof pillars protect occupants in a rollover crash, but they also create blind spots. We determine visibility by measuring the location and width of each pillar using an H-point machine and a laser beam, circuits for a driver and eyeball, respectively. Front and rear visibility are calculated by subtracting the viewable area blocked by the pillars from a perfect 180-degree score.